Hello there, folks. Hey, this is Joe Wazoo here. Got a friend of mine, David, looking for a way to convert his time and seconds into a display that shows minutes and seconds. So here he's got an application David's got where he's got a field that somebody enters in total time in seconds, and he wants to display it on the screen as minutes colon seconds, if you will. For whatever reason, this is what they do. They enter their runtime in seconds and so forth. So his question was, if I put in 128 seconds here, how do I get that display as 2 minutes and 8 seconds? There's 60 seconds in a minute. So how can I display that? So what I did here on this application is I created some tags. I've got time in seconds, which is just an internal tag. Actually, all of them for this because I'm using the emulator to build this. But I got a tag called time in seconds. And then I got another tag called minutes, another one called seconds. And then I made another bonus one called string time, which converts these integer values into an ASCII string. So if you wanted to print that or use it in some other form in a ASCII form, you can. So time in seconds is going to be this field here on the display page. Notice that the field is data entry. And remember, you can always click this button here is the shortcut for data entry, or you can always double click on it on your screen and on the data tab, change it here to data entry, and that'll make that also a data entry field. And then these here are going to be the represented values of it. Now, I wrote a simple program to do this. I suspect you could do this at the tag level as a formula, but I wrote a little simple program here. And this program I wrote it as a function block, really. And it's an interesting, when I say function block, normally you have just program one, but I renamed it function seconds to 2 minutes seconds. That's when I kind of named it. And on this, since it's a function, you can see right here it says int time. If I hit the edit button over here, this function, I have to feed it a variable in the parentheses, which is an integer. It's gonna be the time, and then I'm not returning anything from here. I'm using the external variables here. So anyway, I put in the time in this field here. I'll show you where I'm calling that in a second. And then I take minutes equals the time divided by 60. So if that comes back as 2, 3, or 4, or anything greater than 0, then I know that I have a number of seconds that was greater than 60. If it comes back where, say, they put in 55 seconds, well, that's gonna be, minutes is gonna equal 0 then. In that case, the seconds will be just be equal to the time. But if the minutes is greater than 0, meaning we have 1 minute, 2 minute, you know, let's say we had, again, I'll pick on his example, 128 seconds. Well, that would mean I'd have 2 minutes in there. And then the remainder of that part of that, I have another formula down here that says seconds equals the time. That's the total 128 seconds minus whatever I calculated for here for total minutes right here, whatever I got for minutes times 60. So that would leave me with the 8 seconds left over. And, that does the integer part of it. And then I want a bonus step here, a little further down here. I added did a little bit more where I'm going to convert this to an ASCII string. So I did the same thing here. But in this case, I always wanted that the seconds had 2 digits in it when it prints. So if I find out that the seconds was less than 10, then I'm going to create an internal tag in here. Up here, I declared an internal tag here called C string is a type, and I called a internal tag in this formula, this function called print seconds. And down here, print seconds then would equal, it's an ASCII string, so it's going to be quotations, 0 quotations, plus, and then I'm using the function as text seconds. So this function called as text is going to be over in system over here on the right. I don't know why I have the math open, but I believe you'll find that down here in the strings category. And there's the function right there as text. And of course, you can always right click on that show help info and it'll open up the PDF to explain what that does. But if the seconds if the seconds is greater than 10, then print seconds is just going to equal as text seconds. And then down here is the string time, which is this tag right here. I'm going to do Aztec minutes plus double quotations. I'm going to put the semicolon, or not semicolon, but the colon there with and then a plus again, print seconds. Now this whole function, this function and this simple application is basically called over here on display pages. If I double click on this time and seconds and go to the entry tab down here on entry complete, let me hit the edit button here. Somebody's calling me on my phone. And this is where I'm calling that function. So I have basically went over here to programs. I dragged this out here. Let me just show you here. I'll make another line. So I'll drag this out here like this. And then see how the cursor is blinking inside the parentheses? That's where I need to put the tag time in seconds. So you just simply go over to data tags on the right and you grab this function or this tag time in sections and time in seconds. But notice the black line. I want to drop that right there in between the parentheses and then add a semicolon at the end. And that's that function. I guess up here where it says complex code, I'll put call function seconds. I should do this for the while. Min, this is what's called. So I'll just do that there. Then when I hit enter, it shows it like that. So anyway, if I hit the OK button down below here, let's go ahead and try it out, team. Let's save it. Oh, one more thing I was going to, well, I'll come back to that. Let me go ahead and download this to it. And let's say I put in 55 seconds. So you can see the seconds is 55, minutes zero, because it's less than 60 seconds. And so there's the string tag. Now, if I put in 128, that's what David's working on, you can see that gives me 2 minutes, 8 seconds, and it shows up like this. This was a little bit of a trick here, because I wanted to show 08, and if I didn't do this next thing I'm going to show you, then it just showed as 8 seconds, and this would have also been that string tag makes that be 2:00, not colon, but yeah, that is the colon, 08. Anyway, I'll leave the emulator up and running. Let me go back to data tags on the left, and on the minutes tab, or minutes tag, I didn't do anything on the formatting for that, but if I go to the seconds tag, listen, the seconds tag is going to be anywhere from 0 to, you know, 59, if you will. So in that case, I did a couple things here. On the format tab, I hit the pick button here, and I declared that as a numeric, which gave me access to the fixed data format down here. And so I made that this thing's always going to have 2 digits before. That's all it's going to be, 2 digits. It's going to be 0 through 59. That's 2 digits, if you will. And then I took advantage of this dynamic data formatting by putting 2 in here, which tells it that it's always going to have a leading 0, and I want to display that leading 0. So by doing this dynamic data format here, put a 2 here, that means when it gets to the screen, it's going to put 2 digits there and have a leading 0. That's what I wanted in this case. So again, let me go ahead and download this to it. There's the 128. Let's put in some other numbers. What the heck? I'm not even checking my math, so I'm hoping I'm right. Let's see. 600 seconds is usually 10 minutes. Oh, that's spot on because that's what I do for my screen timeout. How about if I do 655? Wow, that's perfect. So anyway, that's a pretty example of how to convert total time in seconds to a minutes and seconds integer, and also how to make it as a string time, ASCII string, if you wanted to print that somewhere else. Again, the ASCII string, if you hit the poll down here, you can choose a string tag. That's what this one here is called. The rest of these are all X's, which means they are in the integer format. Hey, thanks a lot, folks. Have yourself a great day. If you want a copy of this database, don't be afraid to send me an email, and I'll send it to you. Subscribe to the channel if you want more videos. Have a great day. See you later, folks.